Hi guys, so today we are going to make a really healthy snack, the ragi laddu. Ragi is also known as nachni, finger millet. It has a lot of health benefits. It has calcium, iron, helps with diabetes and various other things. So this is a very ancient Indian grain and it is gluten-free also, so people who prefer having gluten-free snack, this is something which is you can try for. And we are going to make laddus and some people call it energy ball also, so whatever you want to call it. It is a great snack which you can have it, let's say, in the morning, like if you are busy and don't get time to have breakfast in the morning, just have one laddu and go. It is also very good when you travel. So like if you want to, some people carry chocolates and protein bars and so many other things. Just make these laddus and these are very, very good snacks which you can take along. So like it will give you energy. It will keep you full. You don't have to buy anything from outside. This is very healthy and would be really good for you. And this can be used, like as I'm saying, anytime whenever you take a snack, use this laddu. This will keep you full for a longer time and keep you energized. Okay, so a lot of talking done now, so let's start with the video now. In a kadhai, add 1/4 cup of ghee. Add 2 cup of ragi flour to the ghee. So once you have added the ragi flour, mix it thoroughly. And in this process, if you want to reduce the amount of ghee, it is up to you. You can reduce it if you don't like this much of ghee. But one benefit of adding ghee is it is healthy any which ways. Plus, it will help in binding the laddu. So this is how it looks when the ragi get mixed with the ghee. So now what you have to do is keep mixing it for 10 to 15 minutes more till you see the ghee on top. This process is important because it will avoid the ragi flour from burning. So you have to continuously stir it. That is the painful process, but you have to do it for 10 to 15 minutes more. So this is how the mix looked like when you heat it up for 10 to 15 minutes while continuously stirring it. So that you can see the ghee, the shiny part is the ghee, and the texture looks totally different when you started and now. It has it looks like it's softer. It is similar to the clay texture. So now you have to switch off the gas and let it cool for some time and then add the sugar to it. So once the mixture has cooled a bit, add 5 tablespoons of powdered sugar. You can reduce the amount of sugar if you wish to. This is what I prefer adding. So once you add the sugar, keep it aside for some time to cool. And now the mixture is at a temperature where I can touch it easily. It is not that cool, but still easily I can put my hand into the mixture. So I'm just mixing it further so that the sugar mix well with the mix. And now you can start making the laddus. Take a small ball and start rolling it in your hand so that you make nice round circles out of it. So I'll show it to you slowly. You have to press it in your hand and use your fingers to turn it. Okay. So keep an eye on how I turn it. I'll show it to you very slowly, okay? This is oval shaped right now. I'm going to press it, then turn it with my finger. Then press it, turn it with my finger. The mixture is pretty delicate right now, so you won't get exact round shape. That is fine. But keep in mind that you keep 2 laddus with the space between them so that they don't stick together because it is going to get hard once it dries. Okay, so these are the final products: ragi, nachni, finger millet laddu or energy ball, whatever you want to call them, you can do that. Once you make these laddu, keep them in a plate, in a place where they can easily air dry. And once they are air dry, they'll become harder, and you can then shift it to any airtight container or any whichever is suited for you. Make sure there is no water in that container so that it doesn't get spoiled or develop any fungus on it. Okay. Plus, one more tip is, like, if you are adding less ghee in these laddus, if you're not able to bind the laddus at the end, so add 1 or 2 tablespoon additional ghee and make the mix softer. That will help you to bind the laddus further. Okay, so if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and if you have more queries, please put them in the comment section below.